How to make your iPhone faster. If you find that your iPhone is slowing down, there's a few tricks that you can use to make sure that it's running a bit smoother. Generally, your iPhone slows down when you have too many files or too much data stored on your phone. There's a few ways that you can clear a lot of this up. If you go to the General tab under your settings, you can select iPhone storage to see what's taking up a lot of room on your phone. Apps, photos, and media usually take up the most space. So the first step would be deleting any old photos or videos that you may not need anymore, and consider deleting the apps that use the most data. If you want to remove photos and videos from your phone but don't want to delete them entirely, you can always use iCloud photos by clicking enable on the right hand side. Your camera roll also creates a recently deleted album, and this holds photos and videos that you've deleted from your camera roll for up to 30 days. If you're sure that you don't need these anymore, you can just click empty to empty out your deleted album. If you then scroll down more on your iPhone storage page, you can see all the apps that you use on your phone and the amount of space that they take up. Some apps like Instagram don't store files on your phone, but they store data. And if you delete the app and then reinstall it onto your phone, you can clear the data from your phone without losing your account information. So if we were to delete Instagram from our phone and then re-download it, and then if we go back to our iPhone storage, you'll see that the amount of space Instagram takes up on our phone is significantly less. Messages is also a heavy app, and this is usually due to the photos and GIFs and other media aspects that are shared within Messages. People tend to not delete messages often, and if you want to make sure that you are deleting them consistently, you can go back to your settings and then select Messages. Under Message History, you can select Keep Messages and then switch to 30 days or a year so that you're regularly deleting your messages. Another reason why your phone may be running a bit slower is because you have auto updates on. This could either be for your phone or for specific apps. It's helpful to have this on, but because it does slow down your phone a bit, you may want to turn it off. To do that, you can go to General and then select Software Update, and you can click Automatic Updates to turn the toggle off. If you want to stop apps from automatically updating, you can go to the iTunes and App Store, and you can select to keep your app updates off so that you can manually update them. You can also unselect music and apps and books and audio from automatically syncing with the other devices that you have. Your Safari or other browser windows also store a lot of storage with the history, data, and cookies that they keep. If you want to clear this, go back to your settings and select Safari or your other web browser. Then scroll down to find Clear History and Website Data and click. You can then once again click Clear History and Data to remove any history, cookies, and other browsing data stored on your phone. iPhones use a lot of animations when opening apps and switching from different apps. And while this is really nice aesthetically, it does slow down your phone. However, Apple does give you the option to reduce this amount of animation, which you can do by selecting Accessibility from your settings and then clicking the Motion tab. Here you can turn on the toggle to reduce motion, and you can also turn on the toggle to prefer crossfade transitions. Once both of these toggles are on, you'll see that when we close apps or open them, that the motion transitions are no longer used. finally, the last thing that you want to check to make sure that your iPhone is running as fast as possible is your battery health. As your phone gets older, the battery health does deteriorate, and sometimes it may be time for a new battery in order to keep your iPhone moving as fast as possible. To check your battery health, scroll down on your settings and click the battery tab. Then select battery health. As you can see, our maximum capacity is currently 97%. Whenever this gets below 80%, it's probably time for a new battery. There are different tactics that you can use to keep your battery health in check, and one of those is keeping on your toggle to optimize battery charging. If you've done all of this and you still find that your iPhone is extremely slow, you can always try resetting your iPhone. This is done by going to your general settings and then scrolling down to find reset. You can then select to erase all content and settings. Once you click this, you'll be asked for a password, or you can use Touch ID or Face ID to confirm. And then you'll have to log in with your Apple ID to ensure that the information is removed from your device. It's important to note that once you do erase all your content and settings, you lose that information completely. So you'll want to first back up your iPhone either on iCloud or iTunes so that you can use that information again. And that's how to make your iPhone faster. If this video helped you, let us know by liking it or commenting below. And don't forget to subscribe for more how-to instructional videos.